No, in the diagram that you see before you, there are two circuits, circuit A and circuit B. They are identical except for the resistance to the circuit. In circuit A, the resistance is 2 ohm. In circuit B, the resistance is 10 ohm. So, based on your understanding of resistance, you should be able to tell that the current flowing in circuit A, let's call it I, with a small capital A there, will be bigger than the current in circuit B. Why? Because circuit A has low resistance, which means it is easier for current to flow, so the current will be bigger. In a circuit, there can be more than one resistor, with each resistor having its own resistance. So, how do we calculate the total resistance of a circuit which has more than one resistor? There are basically two methods. In the diagram for point number six, you see that there is an electric circuit with two resistors. I label them R1 and R2. So R1 has the resistance of 2 ohm, R2 has the resistance of 3 ohm. So, what is the total resistance in this circuit? If you look at the way R1 and R2 are arranged, you see that there is only one single path for current to flow through them. You can see this from the arrows indicating the current flow. Now, so R1 and R2 are arranged in series. For resistors arranged in series, their total resistance is just the sum of the individual resistance. So the total resistance for this case, I represent with a letter R, with a small capital T written at the bottom. This total resistance is equal to R1 plus R2, which is 2 plus 3 equals to 5 ohm. Now, this next circuit also has two resistors, the same two resistors, R1 and R2, but this time they are arranged differently. Looking at the diagram, looking at the arrows representing the current, you can see that the current flowing out from the electric cell, when it comes to this junction, there are two paths for the current to flow. So the current splits up into two currents. Now, so R1 and R2, we say that they are arranged in parallel because the arrangement provides more than one way for current to flow through the arrangement. So, how do you find the total resistance for this arrangement of R1 and R2? We use this formula, 1 over the total resistance RT is equal to 1 over R1 plus 1 over R2. So, applying the formula, you can see that 1 over the total resistance gives you 5 over 6 per ohm. That is the unit in this case because the unit for resistance is ohm. So, 1 over resistance, the unit is per ohm. This is not the final answer. The final answer is RT. As you can see, RT is equal to 1.2 ohm. Now, something you have to note when calculating total resistance. In this case, notice that R1 is 2 ohm, R2 is 3 ohm. Now, the final answer is 1.2 ohm, which is less than both R1 and R2. So, this is something that you need to take note of. When you calculate the total resistance of resistors in parallel, your answer has to be smaller than each of the individual resistance. This is how you check whether your answer is correct. Referring back to the case of R1 and R2 in series, you see that the total resistance is 5 ohm, which is greater than each of R1 and R2. So this is how you check your answer when you calculate the total resistance of resistors in series. The answer must be bigger than each of the individual resistance.